Hello everyone, after discussing structure of mRNA in this lecture series on genetics and molecular biology, now let us move on to the next session, that is going to be the 7th session in this lecture series. I am Dr. Yogesh Pawde. I recommend you to subscribe to this channel so that you do not miss any notification of the upcoming videos in future. Now moving on to the 7th session in this lecture series, which is under BI 7.1, the structure and function of DNA and RNA and the cell cycle. Under this competency, we are going to discuss in this session the structure of ribosomal RNA and ribosomes. The specific learning objectives of this session are: at the end of the session, phase 1 MBBS student shall be able to describe the structure of rRNA and describe the structure of ribosome in eukaryotes. What are ribosomal RNAs? The ribosomal RNA or rRNA is synthesized by RNA polymerase 1 in nucleolus and ribosomal assembly is produced. Ribosomal RNAs consist of adenine, guanine, cytosine and uracil like other RNAs. But if you remember in the previous session taken on structure of mRNA, we discussed that along with these four nucleotides, which are adenine, guanine, cytosine and uracil, messenger RNA contain methylpurines and methylpyrimidines in addition. Here, the ribosomal RNA along with these four nucleotides, few pseudouridines present in ribosomal RNA structures. Pseudouridines are also present in ribosomal RNA. So there can be an MCQ on this. A ribosome is a nucleoprotein present in cytoplasm containing ribosomal RNA. The ribosomal RNA forms 80% of the total cellular RNA. So if the total pool of RNA including messenger RNA, ribosomal RNA, tRNA, small nuclear RNA, etc., the 80% of the total chunk is going to be ribosomal RNA only. All the ribosomal RNA molecules except 5S rRNA are processed from a precursor of 45S rRNA. What is this S? S is sedimentation coefficient or Swedberg unit. That unit defines the speed or the movement of any particle during centrifugation process. So that is sedimentation coefficient or Swedberg unit. Amongst these various rRNAs present in the pool, 28S rRNA has the peptidyl transferase activity and it acts as a ribozyme in the given ribosome. It is necessary for ribosomal assembly and it plays a key role in the binding of mRNA to ribosomes and its translation process. This is the structure of rRNA. The structure itself has a shape of R. This is the structure of eukaryotic ribosome. And in this eukaryotic ribosome, here these are the rRNAs present, which are indicated with green color. These rRNAs are forming a subunit and these two subunits are forming a total structure of ribosome. Now coming to the formation of large subunit, that is 60S subunit, there are 49 proteins and 3 rRNAs which together comprise a large subunit, that is 60S subunit. Okay, which are the RNAs present here? 5S RNA, 5.S RNA and 28S RNA. 5S RNA is the smallest rRNA which is present in the ribosomal structure. It has 120 nucleotide base pairs. 5.8S RNA has 160 nucleotide base pairs and 28S RNA has 4718 base pairs. Out of these four, only 28S RNA has a peptidyl transferase activity and it acts as a ribozyme, which is a component of large subunit. Together 49 proteins and these three rRNAs, namely 5S, 5.8S and 28S, comprise large subunit which has a molecular weight of 2.8 into 10 to the power 6 daltons. How small subunit, that is 40S subunit, is formed? there are 33 different proteins and one rRNA, that is 18S RNA, which has 1874 nucleotide base pairs, together comprise small subunit, that is 40S subunit, which has a molecular weight of 1.4 into 10 to the power of 6 Daltons. Large subunit, that is 60S subunit and 40S subunit, together form 80S subunit, which has a molecular weight of 4.2 into 10 to the power 6 Daltons, and mRNA binds to this 60S subunit and the protein translation can occur. Now if we compare ribosome of prokaryotes and ribosome in eukaryotic cells, we have seen that there are 4 rRNAs, 5S, 5.8S, 28S, 18S, right? And there are 2 subunits, one is large subunit 60S and small subunit 40S. This is what eukaryotic ribosome has. Here, if we compare the prokaryotic ribosome, it is 70S ribosome, which is comprised of 2 subunits, one is 50S and another one is 30S. This 50S is comprised of 5S RNA and 23S RNA. And this 30S, which is smaller one in prokaryotic ribosome, is comprised of 16S RNA and 21 proteins. So similarly, there are 34 proteins in 50S along with 5S and 23S RNA. So nowhere the sedimentation coefficient of subunits of eukaryotes and prokaryotes are matching. Coefficient of subunits in eukaryotes and prokaryotes are different. This particular fact has a very important application in antibiotic therapies. We'll come to that later on in subsequent slides. Now let us see how these rRNAs are synthesized with different sedimentation coefficients. 5.8S, 18S and 28S, these three rRNAs are synthesized by RNA polymerase 1 as a single unit within the nucleolus, yielding a 45S ribosomal precursor RNA. So these three are derived from 45S ribosomal precursor RNA. The 45S pre-rRNA is processed to 18S of the 40S ribosomal subunit to the 5.8S and 28S rRNA of the 60S ribosomal subunit. Okay, and this 28S RNA has a peptidyl transferase activity which acts as a ribozyme of the ribosome. The transcription of 5S rRNA, which is also found in the 60S ribosomal subunit. So this is common one for prokaryote as well as eukaryote. It takes place outside the nucleolus. This is very important MCQ. The synthesis of 5S rRNA takes place outside of the nucleolus and is catalyzed by RNA polymerase 3, and rest of the rRNAs are synthesized by RNA polymerase 1 and that too within the nucleolus. These MCQs are very important. So far as the structure of ribosome is concerned, in ribosome, these three type of RNAs, mRNA, rRNA, tRNA and the amino acids brought by tRNA will interact together and the translation will occur, leading to protein biosynthesis. Nowhere the sedimentation coefficient of subunits of eukaryotic ribosome and prokaryotic ribosome are matching except 5S. Because it is different, we can safely synthesize or manufacture antibiotics which are targeted against subunits of prokaryotes. And because there is no similarity in eukaryotic cells or in humans, the side effects or inhibition of the protein biosynthesis will not be seen. So we can minimize the side effect of the antibiotics which are targeted against subunits of ribosome in prokaryotes. So for example, tetracycline. So tetracycline inhibits protein biosynthesis by binding with 30S subunit of prokaryotic ribosome. The synthesis by this prokaryotic ribosome is affected because tetracycline has bound to 30S subunit. It will not have side effect on eukaryotic ribosome because this is not matching with subunit of eukaryotic ribosome. So that is the very important application that many antibiotics inhibit bacterial protein synthesis but will not do harm to human cells owing to different sedimentation constants. This was regarding RNA and ribosomes. We have discussed structure of ribosomes, we have discussed structure of rRNA, and this is the literature which I referred to for preparation of the presentation. You also can refer to these references for further studies on rRNAs and ribosome. Thank you very much for watching the video. If you are not yet subscribed, I recommend you to subscribe. If you really like the content, please like, share and subscribe. Keep watching, keep learning and keep motivating us. Thank you so much.